I welcome you all for this today's session on fundamentals of traffic flow. In this class, we are going to discuss about the density, occupancy, spacing and headway. I am Ashok Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand, Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcomes of the today's session. At the end of the session, students will be able to calculate traffic density, occupancy, spacing and headway. First, we will discuss about the density. As we know that it is defined as the number of vehicles occupying a given length of a highway or a lane, it is expressed in vehicles per kilometer or vehicles per kilometer per lane. So if I take the 1000 meter length or 1 kilometer length, in that how many number of vehicles are occupied in a per 100 meter length, 1000 meter length? So it is number of vehicles per kilometer per lane. It depends upon the spacing and some other parameters. It is very difficult to measure directly on the field, because in a 1000 meter you need some elevated observations. If you are standing at an elevated any elevated point, from there if you are able to observe a 1000 meter length, in that you can count the number of vehicles are there in that 1000 meter. So until unless if you are not getting any elevated observation, then it is very difficult to measure density directly on the field. So we need to have for computing this density, we are going to depend upon the speed and flow rate measurement. With this, we can calculate the what is the density of that particular lane. It is very important in terms of quality of a traffic flow, because it directly gives the demand. What is the demand for a traffic engineer? So number of vehicles spaced closely, number of vehicles are spaced largely, and even this will give the driver what kind of the speed he has to select depending upon the spacing available in front of him. So if the spacing is available very less, then he will go with very less speed. If the spacing is more, then he will desire to go with the high speed. So this density and your speed will give the rate of flow. And even density also decides the whether the flow is more or flow is lesser. So then this is one of the macroscopic parameter for any traffic stream flow. It is measured, we know that it is number of vehicles spaced in a length L. So these are the number of vehicles are spaced 1, 2, 3, 4 in a length L. So number of vehicles divided by the L, length L, say 1000 meter or 1500 meter, that gives the number, the density K. So where K is the density in vehicle per unit distance. So unit distance, usually we take it as 1 kilometer, and N is the number of vehicles occupied in some length of roadway in a specified time, and L is the length of roadway. So other the microscopic parameter. Now we are going to go about the microscopic parameter. In this, we will try to discuss about the occupancy, spacing and headway. So as I told you, it's very difficult to measure the density on the field directly. So if you have any modern detectors on the field, we can measure the occupancy. With the occupancy, we can measure the density. So what is the occupancy? Occupancy is defined as the proportion of a time that a detector is occupied or covered by vehicle in a defined time period. So if your detectors are placed, this magnetic detectors are placed on the road surface. So with that, we can how much proportion of time that is the vehicle is occupied and that detector, depending upon the percentage or the proportion of the time it is there on the detector, we can find out the with the occupancy, we can find out the what is the density. So here LV is the average length of the vehicle in meter, and LD is the length of the detector. This is the usually magnet detector. And O is the occupancy over a given detector. With that, we can calculate the density K equal to 1000 into O is the occupancy over given detector, LV plus LD. So in this case, let us take occupancy is 0.2 and a 15 minute analysis period is taken. So within the 15 minute analysis period, what is the occupancy we are trying to find it out. With that correlation, we are finding out the what is the density. So length of the vehicle is 8.5 meter and detector is 0.91 meter. So we can calculate what is the density for 15 minute. We can convert into take it into 1000 meter length. This is 8.5 plus 0.91 and 1000 multiplied by 0.2. That gives you 21.25 vehicles, number of vehicles in per kilometer per lane. So this is the with occupancy we can also calculate the what is the density on that particular section. This occupancy, these detectors are placed in each lane. Suppose you have another adjacent lane, you have to put the another detectors on the another adjacent lane, so that at the end of the day, we can calculate, we can add both the densities, and we can come up with the each lane density on the particular lane. So for that, we have to conduct only for each lane, this occupancy is going to be calculated. Then we can later, we can add this both the density for each lane and left lane and right lane separately. Another term is a spacing. This is a distance between two vehicles measured from front bumper of the vehicle to that of another front wake of front of the vehicle. So front of the bumper of the vehicle, this is the front vehicle and this is the following vehicle. So if I have measured from the front vehicle to following vehicle from bumper to bumper, that is called as a spacing. It is the inverse of your density. So S equal to 1 by K. Now you pass a video for over here and think for a minute and try to give the answer for this. So here it is in a during heavy congestion, it is observed that the average spacing of vehicles in a queue length is innermostly 6.5 meters. Spacing is given for you and ask you to calculate what is the jam density or density for a stopped vehicles. With the spacing, using previous relation, can you able to calculate what is the density over here? I hope you are able to give the answer for this question. The answer for this one is, you can put the spacing equal to, that is I told you, spacing is inverse of your density. So spacing S equal to 1 by K. So in this one, spacing is given. You need to find out what is the jam density over here. So per kilometer, usually I told you the density is calculated per kilometer. So per kilometer is 1000 meter length and spacing is given 6.5 meter. You can calculate 153.85 vehicles per kilometer. This is the density for this question. Going ahead to the another important microscopic parameter is the headway. This is headway is defined as a time interval or a distance between successive vehicles. So it is measured in terms of from distance or in terms of time. Typically, this is measured from bumper to bumper. I told you, either you measure in time or measure in a space. So these are classified into two ways, time headway and space headway. So let us see the time headway. It is difference between the time when the front of the vehicle arrives. Suppose if you are standing over here and measuring the front vehicle, the first one you are recorded at 30 seconds and second vehicle recorded at 33 seconds. Let us run this animation to understand this time headway. Yes, first vehicle is recorded as 30 seconds, second vehicle is recorded at 33 seconds. So deduct this time headway is 33 minus 30. So 3 seconds is the time headway. And how to calculate this time headway? If all the headways are h in a time period t over which the flow has been measured. So I told you these are all the headways. Hi is at measured headways in time. So this is hi equal to t, all the summation and number of vehicles are nt. But the flow is defined as the number of vehicles per unit time. So say 15 minute interval or 10 minute interval, usually 15 minute interval we take, nt is the number of vehicles measured in time t, and we know that the flow is number of vehicles per interval time t. So put that hi equal to t equal to hi, and the q, it becomes hi equal to h average. So that h average is the average headway. So in this case, your nt will get cancelled over here. And the final equation for a flow is Q equal to 1 by Hway. So headway is inverse of your flow. In this case, you can observe the average headway in terms of time is inverse of Q. Suppose in example, if you given 1200 vehicles per hour, this is a flow is given you and ask you to calculate what is the time headway. So here time headway is inverse of flow. You can put the 1200 in your denominator to get the time headway, that is 3 seconds. So 3600 is to convert these hours into seconds. Another one, space headway, it is a distance. Earlier it was a time, now it is a distance. Again, from the distance in the traffic stream, from bumper to front of the bumper to the front of the rear vehicle. So that is measured in time headway in meters. Again, this is if all the vehicles headway in distance x, so x is a distance over which the density has been measured. So SI equal to X. So within the distance of X, you have measured the how many headways in that particular length. So this is usually the density we are going to measure. Say 1000 meter, you have measured n number of headways. That is SI equal to X. But the density K is the number of vehicles NX at a distance of X. So we know that K equal to number of vehicles per unit length. Per unit length, we take it as X. So that is nothing but your total headway you have measured. That is SI equal to X. So put the X equal to SI in this case. So SI equal to S average. That is your average headway distance in meter. And it is inverse of the density. So if I want to calculate the S average, so 1 by K is nothing but your S average. So in this case, density is given 100 vehicles per kilometer, ask you to calculate the space headway. In that case, you can put the 100 as the density, and HS is your headway in meters, 1000 by 100. So 1000 is the total 1 kilometer length you are spaced at 100 meter. So headway is 10 meter. Another the diagram with the this distance and time, we can calculate the time space diagram. We can draw the time space diagram. So these inclined lines are a number of vehicles are spaced, and time with a time and a distance. So with that, this slope of this line gives you the speed. So with the time space diagram, we can calculate flow, we can calculate density. With the flow, we can here Q, it is calculated between T1 and T2. So three vehicles are there. Between a time interval of T1 and T2, we can calculate what is the flow. And in density, between X1 and X2 length, we can calculate is the four vehicles are spaced in the density 1, 2, 3, 4, and divided by the X2 minus X1 gives the density K. These are the references I have used for presenting this presentation. Thank you.